In this video lecture, I'll be discussing about linear block codes. I'm J. Jeneetha Jabaneser, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering at Panimala Engineering College. A linear block code is an error-correcting code for which any linear combination of code words forms a new code word. We know the purpose of error control coding is to enable the receiver to detect and to correct the errors by introducing some extra bits known as the redundant bits in the data to be transmitted. For k number of message bits, if q number of redundant bits are added, the resultant is known as the code word with n number of bits and n is equal to k plus q. A linear block code is represented as n, k code, where k is the number of bits in the message, n is the number of bits in the code word, and q is the number of check bits added. The value of q will be equal to n minus k. In order to understand the principle of linear block code, a simple transmitter and receiver is considered. In the transmitter, channel encoder will be available, and in the receiver, channel decoder will be available. To the transmitter, k number of message bits are applied. For a linear block code, in the channel encoder, a generator matrix will be available. And this generator matrix plays a major role in order to detect the error and correct the error in linear block code. This generator matrix is of the form a generator matrix of order k cross n equal to an identity matrix of order k cross k followed by a parity submatrix of the order k cross q. Now, in the channel encoder, q number of check bits will be added, and this check bits is added based on the principle that the check bits in the form of matrix will be equal to the message bits in the form of matrix multiplied with the parity submatrix. And now, the output of the channel encoder will be a code word represented as X. It will be having n number of bits, wherein this n will be equal to k plus q. The code word is of the form message followed by check bits. This can also be obtained by the code word in the form of matrix equal to message in the form of matrix multiplied with the generator matrix. This code word X is transmitted and it is received as Y by the receiver. In order to detect and correct the error, at the receiver side, a parity check matrix will be available. This parity check matrix is derived from the generator matrix such that the parity check matrix is equal to P transpose matrix. That is, in generator matrix, we have a P matrix. The transpose of that will be here as P transpose matrix followed by identity matrix of the order Q cross Q. This parity check matrix has a special property that once you multiply the received code word with the transpose of parity check matrix, the result will be equal to zero whenever there is no error. And if there is a error, the result will not be equal to zero and it will be equal to a non-zero value, and that non-zero value is indicated as yes. So, the non-zero value is also called as a syndrome, and the decoding procedure is called as syndrome decoding. After getting the syndrome, we'll be having a decoding table in the channel decoder. This decoding table is nothing but the error pattern followed by the syndrome. So this syndrome will be searched for in the decoding table and the corresponding error pattern will be obtained. Finally, the error pattern will be added with the received code word in order to get the correct code word X. So this is how the errors will be detected and corrected using linear block codes. So now we'll consider an example problem for a 7,4 linear block code with a given generator matrix. Find the code vector, draw the encoder diagram, find the parity check matrix, construct the syndrome decoding table and decode the received code word 1100010. So we know very well a linear block code in general will be represented as n, k code. So from that we can get the value of k as equal to 4, n as equal to 7, q as equal to 3, that is n minus k. So in general I can consider the 4 message bits as m0, m1, m2, m3 and the 7 bits in the code word as x0 to x6 and the 3 bits in the check bits as c0, c1, c2. From our discussion, we know very well the code word in the form of matrix can be obtained as the message bits in the form of matrix multiplied with the generator matrix. So I can just consider only one message, that is 1110. I know very well the code word in the form of matrix will be the message bits multiplied with the given generator matrix. So applying matrix multiplication, we can generate all the 7 bits as shown below. So finally, I'll be getting the code word as 1110100. So the first 4 bits indicates the given message and the next 3 bits indicates the check bits which is added. So we also know that we can get the relationship between the check bits as well as the message bits by the equation. Check bits in the form of matrix will be equal to the message bits in the form of matrix multiplied with the P matrix or the submatrix. So we can obtain the P matrix from the generator matrix. So the generator matrix is identity matrix of order k cross k followed by P matrix. So removing the identity matrix, I can get the P matrix. So now we know C is equal to C0, C1, C2 and M is equal to M0, M1, M2, M3 and we have obtained the parity matrix or P matrix. So we can apply matrix multiplication and get the relationship between C0, C1, C2 and M0, M1, M2, M3. By applying matrix multiplication, I'll be getting the value of C0 as equal to M0 exclusively or with M1 exclusively or with M2. Similarly, I'll get the value for C1 and C2. So now I can calculate the code vector for all the 16 different message bits. Since there are 4 bits in the message, the total possible combination of message bits will be 16, starting from 0000 till 1111. So applying this relationship, I can calculate the value of C0, C1, C2 for all the 16 different message bits. Finally, the code word will be message bits followed by the check bits. And after obtaining the code word, I can calculate the weight of the code word, which is nothing but the total number of non-zero value available in the code word. So I'll be calculating the weight of the code word. So D minimum can be obtained from the weight of the code word. The minimum weight of the code word is equal to D minimum. So d minimum value is equal to 3. From this d minimum value, I can find out the number of errors that can be detected by this code as well as the number of errors that can be corrected by this code for the given Jeneetha matrix. So the relation is d minimum should be greater than or equal to s plus 1, where s is the total number of errors that can be detected. So for this given problem, the value of s is equal to 2. Similarly, d minimum is greater than or equal to 2t plus 1, wherein t is the total number of errors that can be corrected for this given Jeneetha matrix. So applying the formula, the number of errors which can be corrected is equal to 1. So next we'll see how to draw the encoder diagram. Since there are 4 bits in the message, I'm just considering 4 bits for the message. So the message is indicated as M0, M1, M2, M3. And we are going to add 3 check bits, which I'm going to consider as C0, C1, C2. And we know very well the operation which is performed is modulo 2 addition. So I'm just considering 3 modulo 2 adders. So we know the equation or the relation between C0 as well as the message bit. C0 is equal to M0 exclusively OR with M1 exclusively OR with M2. So I can get the relationship for C0 as M0, M1, M2, which is exclusively added. Similarly, I can get the value of C1. So C1 is M0, M1, M3 added together and we'll be getting C1. So next is C2, which is equal to M0 exclusively OR with M2 exclusively OR with M3. So we can just apply the connections and get the value for C2. So at the output of the encoder, we'll be having the switch. Initially, the switch will be connected to the message bit so that I'll be getting the 4 message bits. And after getting the message bits, the switch will be connected to the position of check bits so that I'll be getting the check bits. We'll be finally getting the code word, which is message followed by the check bits. So in order to detect and correct the error, we know very well at the receiver side, we need what is called as the parity check matrix. So we know the given P matrix and it is equal to 111, 110, 101, 011. So we can get the P transpose matrix interchanging rows and columns. The value of P transpose can be obtained as shown. So we know the H matrix or the parity check matrix is P transpose matrix followed by identity matrix of order Q cross Q. And H transpose matrix will be obtained by interchanging the rows and columns of H matrix as shown. So now we can form the syndrome decoding table. Since this code will be able to correct only one error bit, I know very well the error bit can be either in the first bit, second bit, or even in the seventh bit. So I'll write all the possible error patterns followed by the syndrome. The syndrome is nothing but rows of H transpose matrix. So directly we can obtain the H transpose matrix and fill the rows of H transpose matrix in order to obtain the syndrome. So in the problem, we are supposed to decode the received code word 110010. So in order to decode, the first step is multiply the received code word with H transpose matrix. So once we multiply this, we'll be getting the value of the syndrome. So the syndrome obtained is 011. So search for this syndrome in the decoding table. So I have 011 here And now I'm going to obtain the corresponding error pattern. So the corresponding error pattern, what I'm going to obtain will be 0001000. And the final step is add the error pattern with the received code word. So once I add the received code word along with the error pattern, I'll be getting the corrected code word. The corrected code word is 1101010. So this is how we are going to detect the error and correct the error using linear block codes. So now we'll see certain important terms with respect to minimum distance of block codes. First is the Hamming weight. It is defined as the number of non-zero components. That is, if I consider the code word as 1100110, so the total number of non-zero value what I have is 4, and that is nothing but the Hamming weight. So next is Hamming distance D. So if I consider two code words, the number of times which they differ is called as the Hamming distance. So for the example what we have considered, the difference is only 4. They are differing in the first bit, second bit, third bit, and next they are differing in only the sixth bit. So total number of times in which they differ is equal to 4, and that is nothing but the Hamming distance D. So next is the minimum Hamming distance, D minimum. It is defined as the smallest distance between any pair of code word. For example, D minimum is equal to minimum value of D. So now we'll see the advantages and disadvantages of linear block code. Advantages: it's the easiest and simplest technique to detect and correct errors, and error probability is reduced by using this technique. So the major disadvantage is transmission bandwidth requirement is very high, and extra bits reduces bitrate of transmitter and also reduces its power. And it finds its major application in satellite and deep space communications. Then it finds its application in digital audio and video transmissions. It finds its application in computer memory and single error correcting and double error detecting codes, storage magnetic and optical data storage in hard disk.